Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, welcome to the stream, welcome to the man cave, welcome to the workshop. I'm hoping everything's working tonight. I'm very dopey head. I had a migraine at the weekend and I'm telling you what, it's probably the worst migraine I've had in a good 5 years, and I was asleep so I couldn't do anything about it, so I had to battle through the pain on Sunday. I took the drugs that I meant to take as soon as I'm supposed to, but the it leaves me dopey. So you've probably seen it in a couple of videos that I say things wrong. I couldn't even say Ladder 9 New York fire truck yesterday. So having problems there. Hello, Christian from Grantham.
Let's give it up big time. Hello, Christian from Grantham. Now let's get cracking.
I don't know, Lou. You know what? I'm tending to think it was left hand. Is Tom Hanks left-handed? I'm sure it was left hand. It makes sense that it was right hand, but I'm sure it was left hand. Am I right? Do I win a prize? You're worried about the... No, the Rams had a blinding weekend. Absolutely blinding. I was happy. My son's happy because the Dolphins did well as well. I don't think Spruverse is too happy. The old Chargers didn't do very well. But there you go. We are going to be doing the X-Wing tonight. Now, if you noticed that I actually found the bits. Now, I've sealed that anyway. Look, they go in that bit there. So I told you I did have them somewhere. But there you go. But today, when we continue this, we're just going to be hiding all those bits all over again. So it's not gonna happen. But that's the beauty of this build, that we actually get to hide things. Right, couple of things before we start tonight. The first thing is that today, I believe, is the last day that you can give to the sponsorship for the workshop. Now, I've actually called it something now. This is the site. As you see, we've blasted through the target. We've got 125 supporters, so thank you all so much for that. I'll put the link up on the screen there as well. I am really, really, like, I don't know. I'm moved. I'm moved by that, but I'm calling it the workshop legacy. So what I'm doing is, for all the supporters that have gone into that, obviously I said there's going to be a brick on the wall,
give it up big time.
With your name on it or whatever you want me to put on it.
But hello, Christian.
It's going to be an October to start making them,
and now let's get cracking.
And we'll attach them to the side of the workshop for the life of the workshop. So it is the legacy of the workshop, so your name will be on the legacy of the workshop for all time. Now, I didn't know how this workshop was actually being made. So for that, oh, is it 9 p.m. this evening? Oh dear, I didn't realize, Ian. Sorry. Okay, you got an hour. stupid me. I will get to chat in a second, but the there is, I don't know how it got built. I haven't got a clue, because obviously apparently it was arranged in May. You probably heard the write-up on Agora Models that Ian Campbell did for part work up for Agora Models. It was absolutely brilliant. But the see what I mean about being dopey? I'm losing track. But the video is coming out Thursday, and it's going to be on the Oligo Models site. Now, what I've done for Oligo Models YouTube site, I've created a Bitly link, so it's easy to find it. But if you just go to YouTube and type Oligo Models, like you see down there, you'll find it. It will be the top one. Now, that's going to be going live at 7 p.m. on Thursday, and I will be tuning in as well, because I haven't seen it. I don't know what happened. I don't know what scheming was done. I don't know what Mrs. World of Wayne's done. Haven't got a clue. So I'm eager to see what's going on there big time. So it's going to be good. It's going to be absolutely brilliant, actually. you've got the camera change Grant from trick again. Oh, have I? Oh, hang on. There we go. I've turned it off. There we go. Look, so I'm gonna switch cameras just to prove it's working. Hang on, stand by. There you go. Look, strip cameras and back. I fixed it. You see, I'm fuzzy headed. This is gonna make for a car crash stream tonight. That's for sure. But before we start, I've got it's only, hello Bruce. How's it going? Are you okay, Bruce? Look, the sorting hat. Oh, you can't see it. It's just off. Look, it's here, and it's working now. I showed this off last time, and I keep.
Daring, better be Gryffindor.
Been having an enormous amount of fun with that, but where was I? The squirrel moments, big time. Now I've got an apology to make. See, I make these bold statements on the channel, and I don't think things through, and as a matter of fact, I'm so set in my ways that I won't believe anything that anyone tells me. Now, one of the biggest questions I've had regarding the Bismarck is, can it float? Can it float? And I'm like, it's full of plates. Of course it can't float. It's too heavy. The displacement's wrong. The balance is wrong. It will just roll over and topple over, and it will just die a death. Well, you know, I'm sitting there on my little throne saying that's the way of it. I won't listen to anything else until Michael Barry Weir comes along. And he sent me some stuff which you really need to see. He's actually done it. So it's a remote control boat. Believe it or not. So like, check this out. This is the Bismarck in a bath. Then we've got, look, spirit level on there as well. Just checking the balance there. Look, that's the water up the side of it. He's made it all remote control. So all the remote control parts are in there as well. Look at that. Then he's done a little bit of video footage here. And he's even got steam coming out the funnel section. Which I think is absolutely amazing. So never again am I going to say that something can't be done, because I'm wrong and it can be done big time. Have a crack. And you know what, I've got a coffee somewhere. It's behind here. I'm trying to like slap myself awake. All right, now Daniel, he's Dan over at Oligo Models. He's at that stage now where until you get to 100 subscribers, you can't name your own channel. So for now, Dan's channel is probably youtube.com, UC, capital T, little Z, number one. But when he gets to 100 subscribers, he can actually call it Oligo Models. So he's after 14 more subscribers. So if you click on that link that I put earlier, and I'll show you that on the screen now, or just type that in. Well, I'm sure one of the mods will put the link in chat as well. There you go, Mrs. Welder Wayne has. Just go over to that and subscribe to that. Once he gets over to 100, he can actually make his URL a lot more user-friendly, if you like, which is excellent. That's an epic update, isn't it, of the... I still can't believe it. I still can't believe that someone has managed to get the Bismarck to float. Absolutely crazy. Now, the only other thing is the Patreon cards. When I mentioned the Patreon cards last week, let me just pick a comment. Well, it couldn't be done out the box. No, it couldn't be done out the box. So what you said was true from a certain point of view. Everything's true from a certain point of view, Lou. No, that was excellent. I knew you were in here, Michael. So I was just teasing everyone for that. But that was amazing. When I saw that, I couldn't believe it, to be honest with you. So I had to watch it a few times. Now, the Patreon card. Now, last week when I was telling people how I think this Patreon card works, a lot of you have moved to your bands, so you've got up bands and stuff. So I'm just going to tell you again what I believe it is. Now, this might be give or take 50 cents either way, but the dark blue is from a dollar. The what color is that? I'm colorblind. Like a cyan blue, whatever that blue is there. I think that's $2. From $5 upward, $2 to $5, from $5 upwards is yellow, and then from $10 upwards is green. That's how that works. But you should see everyone's name in there now. And if you've requested your name to be changed to something else, like Koza at the top, or Dr. Inferno, or we've got quite a few in there actually, RJ, Shriptide, There's loads in there. But if you have got some that need to be changing, then obviously just drop me an email or drop me a message on Patreon. And I will sort that out for you, no problems at all. God, Oligo's 100. God, he's 100 already. Oh. But yeah, that's what happens when you put your mind to it. I can't believe that. I mean, wow. Wow. Can you imagine that, taking that down your boating lake, though? That's not light, Michael. That's not light at all. I mean, I have enough trouble putting it on the shelf there. So a couple of things I've added. If you've seen last time, I've got the Star Trek plaque up there. I did stick it up, but it fell down, so I've screwed that in now. And also Shane Chapel. Look, there's the Rootmaster thing that you're asking about. I've put that up there now, because obviously we've got the Rootmaster coming. Just say Teal rather than Cyan. Easy to pronounce. Lou, you know what? Back in the days of the ZX Spectrum, I think the number key F5 or 5 was Cyan. But I used to call it Cyan, and no one ever corrected me. So it's really hard for me to change to Cyan. when I've always known it as cyan. So this was back in the day that you had, oh, I can't remember, magenta, yellow, all these funky colours on the ZX Spectrum. But all fun. You've gone to premium YouTube. I don't even know what that is, Craig. All I know is that my long videos seem to be placing loads of ads in there, which I can't really do anything with, which is a bit crazy. But we are going to be doing stages 86. Well, now, let me show you what we've got here. Look, we've got, let's just hide that message. We've got 86 to 90. I don't think we're going to get through all of these. I did have to make a little change, though. Someone did advise me that the X-Wing is there, that you can't shut this cockpit canopy if the front of the cockpit isn't screwed down, which meant that I had to undo all of this, take the cockpit out, and sure enough, there's two screw holes to screw the front of the cockpit down. And for my life of me, I can't remember ever being told to do that. So I've done it now. So that's all stuck down. You should request a plug-in, chat. Wait a minute. Why have we got Mrs. Wilder Wayne? Wait a minute. Bergdis, I'm trying to click on your name and it goes to Mrs. Wilder Wayne. What's the price? There's no price. I just type it in. Like, put your link in for your channel and then I just type anything and then it comes up. I've got quite a few on here, but we're getting there, Bergdis. I'm sorry I couldn't give you the news you wanted today about Eagle Moss or yesterday, but it is what it is. Wow, we got like an autofocus on this screen as well. So I think we're just going to get straight on with it. Which is going to be fun. I'm just going to hide that. It looks like we've got some fiddly parts tonight. So this is probably going to go severely wrong. Now remember, when I do these build nights, very hard again for me to check out on chat. So the moderators are in there to hopefully answer questions, supply you links and stuff like that. But I will try and glance over when I can for when I'm building. Now I'm probably going to have to start off with that camera, which looks good. And I think we will get on with it, which is going to be fun. So today I enjoyed doing that Peugeot, I have to say, but it took a lot longer than I thought it would. That's why most of the videos that have been coming out lately have been coming out in early afternoon in the UK, because they're just taking so long to do. So long. Right, I'm just going to cut all these open. I'm going to do what they've done in the magazine here. Let the car crash begin. Oh, Shane, you're in here. Excellent. See, Shane, look, it's up on the wall now. I've got the Routemaster bus as well, which is going to go on the workstation side. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to lay this out exactly like they wanted me to in the instructions, which means that I need this little gadget here, which I'm going to lie down there. And I'm going to put this exactly as they've laid it out, because by doing that, things can't go wrong. Please, they can't go wrong. So we have one that side, one that side. This is just basically going to help me to where things go. We've got this one here. Then we've got that one there. Then we've got two of these. One. Oh, God. They're very similar. yeah, car crash already. So that's these big ones. Two. Then we've got this there. Then we've got the little thing that goes on the end of that, which is a round thing. Oh, God. This isn't good. Right. Am I missing something? Forget the round thing for a minute. I'll try and find that in a second. So then we've got that one there. Then we've got two of these. One, two. Then we've got, oh, I don't know what that is. And then I've got these two parts here. That's the top of that one, I think. Yep. Which means that one must be something up there, I guess. And then we've got these two here. Right. Hopefully, that's going to make everything easy for me. I've got to put these on exactly like you just saw. Ah, the Titanic. Yes. Did anyone get an email today? Just saying that the Titanic's coming out on the 22nd of January. Now, what I can't see is this bit's just going in here, by the way. I'm just going to start putting them on this. I can't see anything which says that's UK, even though it's been sent to a UK email, which is a bit weird. I'm just seeing how these go in. These go in this way. But I mean, that's going to be good news if that is true. The funny thing is, I did ask Eagle Moss about the Titanic in the UK recently, and they said they've got no news. So I don't know. I don't know. But if that is down for a January release, obviously, I think, can you believe for the Ecto 1, we've only got like 35 stages left to go? Because it's 141 stages, isn't it? That's those two in the Ecto 1. So yeah, not long, and then that one's going to be complete. All of this is just plug and play, as you can see. Pushing them in as hard as I can. They don't come out, so they don't need glue. Yeah, Phoebe, I don't know if anyone saw my social media. She ripped up one of the things that Mrs. Wilder Wayne was working on. A rabbit, sort of like a lavender rabbit that you fill full of stuff and it smells of lavender. But yeah, she did well. Okay, stand by. I'm just looking at what's the next bit. Take this strip, which has two locating pins. Ask this one here. That's going in there. Why couldn't they just mold this as one piece? I don't know if it makes a difference if this was molded as one piece or if it looks like it is looking there. Bit crazy. Then we've got to put these semicircular things in and they face outwards. So one in that side and one in this side. There we go. Look, this is going easy. I'm going to speak too soon, but it looks good. Put this end here on this little pin. Whoops-a-daisies. Get in there. There we go. That's slanted up. They've got it slanted towards the middle, so I think that's about right there. And this is going on this section just here, I believe. Which is going to be a bit tricky because unless that's pushed all the way down. There we go. We've got that in. It's a little bit crushed. Let's see if I can fix that a little bit. I think if I muck around with that, I'm going to have a bad time. So it is what it is. That one's in. Then we're going to be putting this starry shaped thing in. I'm sure all of these have got names. They call this the... Nope, they're just calling it a detail. This is a semicircular pattern, so it can only go in one way. There we go. That's that one in. Then we've got these tiny ones to go in, again, facing outwards. One there. One on this side. Ah, see, laying it out. It's brilliant. Then we've got, oh my God, what the hell's that? Right. We've got this one going into the hole here, just over the edge. Get in there. Nope. Okay. Is this the first one that don't want to go in? Nope, that one's in. Perfect. Almost there. Let's put the next page on. Wayne, I was saying is that only two of the smokestacks were real and the other two were dummies on the Titanic. Ah, yeah. We mentioned that the last live stream. This bit here is somehow going to go in there and it is directional. So again, I'm going to use my tweezers to help me. Put that in there and push that down. Excellent. There is two tiny little holes in there, which we're going to need now because we're going to be putting the pipe work in. And the first bit of pipe work we need looks like this. And I think I'm going to put my glasses on for this because you know this is going to get messy. So we put one in the hole here, and the other one in the hole there, and the last one in the hole there. Oh, that's gone in perfect. It shouldn't come out. And on the other side, exactly the same. We're going to put one in the hole there and the other one just into the hole there. So, wow, that went quite well. That's rare for me. So all of those are in place, and it's saying you can do a dry fit now onto the hyperdrive system, which is this. We've got this spindle here is going to go right through the center of these, and all the rest are going to line up with these two here, and I'm hoping everything else lines up. So I'm going to line this one up first, and I'm going to have a look. It's looking good. This one's a little bit off. Stand by. I'm trying to get these into the holes. Out that one's in. Perfect. Right, it's looking good. Right, it is. Everything's in. Wow. Okay, which means now we have got us to screw this together. We're using XW08 screws, and I think the first one I'm going to put in are the two at this end. That's one. Watch them bring out Poe Dameron's X-Wing. You know what, the as I've been going along this build, I haven't enjoyed this one, I have to say. I haven't enjoyed the build, but now it's getting near the end, I kind of like how it looks. I think it looks really good. So I'm wondering, what didn't I like about it? Was it just the way it goes together? It's just all like piecing together a bit like Lego? I don't know, but obviously the end result is really looking good. Okay, so we've got one in here. We're almost there. And then we've got one just into this end over here. And there we go. That is one. I'm just gonna tidy up here. One completed hyperdrive unit, which doesn't look too bad, does it? Very cool. Now they said we can do a test fit for this. I'm guessing it goes behind R2-D2. Let me just put this down. And it goes this way round, I'm guessing. So I'm guessing this goes in here somehow. Is that right? I don't know. I haven't got a clue. In like that, I'm guessing. I hope so. Looks all right, though. Looks all right. I don't know if it's supposed to fit lower than that, but there you go. That's what that looks like. So that's the end of that stage. I'm so nervous about moving that. Let's have a look what we got in stage 87. I just go to hear the accent. What's that? Lots of medieval looking buildings in Durham. Oh my god. Let's get to the magazine. Hello, what's that showing there? That's interesting. Okay, we're gonna be, oh god, we are working on the ship. So we're gonna be, let's have a look. Oh, we're putting the nose in. We're putting the nose on the ship. This is gonna be where the car crash happens. Connecting the wires. I haven't got to do this. This has already been done. I've already done this bit here previously. Match up the plugs and sockets. Putting a, what are we doing there? It's asking me to test the electrics. I'm not gonna do that again. Did that last time. We're going to make sure the switches come out, and then we're just putting this nose section on. Okay, we can do that. Let's see how this goes. Not looking forward to this. Okay, so let's just get the pack out. This is pack 87, and we've got all sorts of weird and wonderful stuff here, and two lots of screws. That's XW02 and XW01. Put these to one side. So the first thing it wants me to do says take the wires leading from the antenna and feed them in the middle of the framework like this, so you can pass the back of the nose assembly and its mount. Make sure the front of the nose assembly is correctly aligned. Right, okay, so let's bring this over now. I want to put it on the bit that you can actually see it there. So what it wants is these bits here put through the center section here, and it was talking about an extension lead there. That's what this little clip is there, but that is all the way through. So I'm guessing, once I got this on, I have got to put the nose piece on. So how does this go? This goes underneath somehow. Whoops. Oh, look, there's a magnet in there. Why have they got a magnet in there? Stand by. I'm going to keep that to one side for a second. There's two magnets in there. We've got to mount this on the frame. It's not really helping me where it goes. I've got three. Oh, I see. All right, okay. Little help. I've got some. Aha, right there. That's where it goes. Okay. So I've aligned that, and it's going to be put in with two XW02 screws, which are right in the middle there. Let's get them out. And of course, I've just got the whole X-Wing sitting on my scalpel, which I don't want to move at the moment. Oh, there it is. Actually, I can get it. If I'm making a mistake, please just shout at me and I will glance over. It's more entertaining than what's on Sky. It's when the things start to go wrong. It does make me laugh, because I'm sure you peeps just prefer it when things go wrong. Just making sure that this lines up. There is some locating holes in here. There we go. So, two screws. One here. We have got a nose on the X-Wing. And one over this side. Excellent. And then secure the back of the nose assembly with a single XW01 screw, which means, just looking around, I've got to turn it over, have I? Looks like I've got to turn it over. Okay. Stand by. I really don't want to move this. Okay, let's see what happens when I move it. I'm going to just put it up upright for a second and move my camera over just to make sure that you can see something. Stand by. Ah, there we go. What's an XW01 screw? Just in there. I think. Nope, not there. Just in here. At the back. I was way off. Okay. That is the nose section in place. And I've got a squeaky chair. Okay, let's see what else we've got to do. I've done the matching up of the plugs. Install four AA batteries, I've done that. Turn on the main switch, don't need to do that. There's no need to test it. Unless you want me to. Do you want me to test it again? No, we're not going to test it again. We know it works. But I am going to move this out of the way now, because we don't need that for a second. They've got us making... Oh, take the main hull panel. That's... Let me change the camera, which is this one here, looking like that. We need to put this on it, which is the internal torpedo tubes, and they go on this way over the top and are held in with XW02 screws, just two of those. So one in here. Test it. You want me to test it? Okay, once I've got this panel on, we'll test it at the end of this one. Okay, I promise. We did that last time, so. But you never know. Something might have changed since last time, because I have moved the cockpit around. Oh, that didn't sound good. That's in, though. Okay, so we've done that. Now we're going to be bringing back the X-Wing. I just want to see where it goes, and then I'll... It goes on the underside, so it's going to be going... Let's swatch the cameras around. It's going to be going... I don't know, somewhere here, I guess. Is that right? It looks right. Align the assembly with the end of the nose. Yes. And press it into place. So it's pressed in. Oh, it's got studs. Right, okay. So let's get that bit out of the way. Ah, well, there we go. Look, we're pushing this in. See what I mean about pushing models? Hear that click into place then? I think, making sure that's smooth. Now, if I push the top in, the bottom comes out. But they are definitely all in. So there we go. An armoured panel into place. Mirror steps 18 and 19 to fit the port side. Oh no, we've got the sides to put in. Press the panel firmly into place. So we've got this panel here to put in, which I'm not sure what one goes in where. I'm guessing, let's have a look. I'm just seeing which one's got the better fit. Ah, this one goes in this way, I'm guessing. There we go. And that's nice and flush. And we do the same on the other side there. Let me just turn that around just a touch. I'm not happy with that bit just there. Just checking everything, make sure that's out of the way. Can you hear all that cracking as it goes in? There we go. Cool. We've got a little bit of a lip on there. Not really much I can do about it because it is just a push-in panel there. But there we go. That, so I'm going to change the head cam. That's that one done. Can you see that? So we've got a full nose piece, but you can see that lip in there. I don't quite know how I'm going to get rid of that. Haven't got it on the other side. I reckon glue might end up being my friend on that. We'll see on that one. But you want me to test it, so I'm gonna have to get the remote control. 1 second. Okay, we did this last time. Put my mic back on. Please let, did anyone see? I can see your message, Arsena. Okay, so we're going to turn it on. It's getting very heavy now. So I'm hoping I can hold it. Whoa, Jesus. So if I press one of them buttons, the cockpit light comes on. Don't know if you can see that. There you go. And turns on. This is the engine lights, which, as you can see, whoops, one of the engines bent round, are on. Turn that off. Stand by. Then we've got, oh God, it's so big. This one here, which is the cannons here, which you're probably not going to see because of the studio lights. It's so big. R2-D2, as you can see, he's doing what he does, lighting up. And then the wings. You ready for this? Excellent. So we are still all working good. I'm gonna place this down here. Oh. And I've turned it off. Always impressive when we get to see it, isn't it? So that's another one done. Yep, nice to see I've gave Dobby something to do. Yeah, look, he's holding the latest blueprints from Partwork Upgrades. All of these blueprints. I've been saying to Ian, every build I do, I want Dobby to be advertising what I'm doing. So obviously he's got the X-Wing here now. So, but you can get them through partworkupgrades.com, which is cool. He was just going to say glue. I haven't really got a choice, have I? One of the engines is bent. One of my engines or one of the other engines? Don't know, it looks to me. Oh yeah, yeah, the engines are bent all over the place. They just straighten up afterwards. Don't worry too much about the engines. It's I think it's a safety feature to stop it breaking, but we'll have to see. Okay, so back to the overhead camera. This is stage 88. What are we doing? Oh, it looks like we're doing some more paneling here. We're going to be putting a plate over the batteries. We're going to be putting what's that? Fit the tab onto the long edge of the matching, press the cover into place, take the cargo bay hold plate and line up the power socket. We've got a power socket in that? Oh, we have. Oh, so can we power this? I don't know. Okay, fair enough. And then we're going to be attaching this to the X-Wing. And then, oh look, the camera's all over. I'm going to leave the camera where it is at the moment. And then we're going to be adding some cockpit fittings. Oh, this is going to be fiddly. Take care, Mega Nico. See you later. The cockpit does have lights, Andy. Did you see those? Okay, so what we're going to do is, I think this time I'm going to, rather than put it upright, I'm going to try and lie it down. I can't think I'm going to break anything if I lie it down. And I'll get all of the cameras. Oops, what was that? Oh, that was R2-D2. Let me just take R2 out. Don't want to break R2. You can stay there. Should be able to lie it down. Excellent. So let's play around with some cameras here. So we've got that one there. This camera here can go up a touch, because we're working on this battery bay area here. Cool. Excellent. So let's pick out, where are we? Stage 88. Got that here. Hopefully we can see everything. And get all these parts out. Okay, take cover and line it up with a frame this way round. Okay, so I've got the cover, line it up with a frame this way round. I don't know what way they've got it. Is it that way? It's that way round. Okay, so that's in there like that. Secure the cover with an XWR8 screw. I can do that. Excellent. It's very hard to show you this. Oh, I've just dropped an XWR8 screw. Let's get another one out. God knows how many screws I've already got on the floor in this workshop. So that's the battery bay is now protected. So take the cargo bay hull plating and line up the power socket, this one here, with the matching housing. So it's going to go into here. Just seeing if it's got a certain way it needs to go. What way have they got it? They're putting it in. I'm just putting it in the way that they've got it so that I don't go wrong. They're putting it in this way. So there you go, that's in. Not in very well though. I'm sure it should be, there we go. Nice and deep in there, but the innuendos are started. There we go. So that's in place. I'm just making sure it's straight. Yep, and it's straight. So there we go, we've got a power socket in there now. Don't strain the wiring. I haven't done that. Make sure the metal pin in the socket is centralized in the hole. Yes, it is. Fit the switch through the hole in the other panel. All right. So this switch is going in here. Oh my God. Now it gets tricky. Okay. I've got the switch in there. Don't strain the wire. Gently press the switch into a housing, making sure that it's fully seated. It is fully seated. Okay. Match the pins of the cargo bay hole plated with the ones on the frame. Oh God. Okay. Where's it going? It's going over the top of this section. So we've got pins on this side. Let's push those wires through. Then we should be able to push this down into place here. Is that right? It's not exactly the best fit, I have to say. I'm just pushing these wires in as best I can get them in. they're in, but they don't hold themselves very well. See, look. One, two. I'm doing each individual one. Three, four, five. There we go. It's in. Had to stand up for that one. Wow. Just making sure it's level, which it is. Matched up the pins of the lower hole plating. That's this. And put it on the frame. So that's going down this end here. Wants me to match up the pins for this one. which I'm guessing is in here. Which I'm lining up each one of these pins. And there we go. That's that plate in there. Excellent. Very good. Let's pick this up. Put this to one side. We seem to be making a lot of... Well, what's up to that camera? I must have dropped it. Your message is blocking the view. Hang on, I'll take that off. Sorry about that. Okay, so we're going to be adding some cockpit fittings now. In other words, little tiny details. It says, take the pilot's hand control, which is this, and the joystick, which is this, and put one end of the joystick has a ridge around it. Take the other end and match it up with a D-shaped hole in the control panel, which goes in here. Like that, I'm guessing. That looks good. Although there one goes the other way around. That's strange. Right, hang on. Ah, there we go. So it's that way around. So the ridge section is pointing down. See? Almost made a mistake there. Oh, you've got to be joking me. I've got to bring over the blinking thing again. Okay, this time I want the cockpit facing upwards. So I shouldn't have really put this cover on, should I? Okay, so lift the cockpit hood up there. You know what, I'm going to take this off because I don't want it getting damaged. And then this is going somewhere. Okay, it's going what way around? It's going to be going this way around into the hole at the very front. You can't really see it, but trust me, there is a hole there. Just making some sort of like joystick for the cockpit area there. Fit the cranked end down the hole in the back of the cockpit. This is this pipe which what have I done with it? Did it stick to me? Oh, there it is. Look, I'm losing things. Right, so we've got this pipe here, which is going, God, I can't figure this one out. Right, okay, from the back to the front. Right, okay, so standby, it's going from the back of the targeting computer into, right, I see. So that's going into there. I'm gonna need my tweezers and my glasses for this. Let's have a look at this again. One end in here, the other end into the back of the targeting computer. Ugh. This is why you need glue, I think, for this. Put that in. Excellent. That's that bit in. Whew. Very good. Wow, that's all there is to do in that stage. We are whizzing through it, aren't we? Okay, pick this one back up again. Put this to one side and we'll look at the next one. Okay, stage 89. We are getting there. We are doing fitting the life support hoses. Why is it always hoses? Again, we're adding some lot more details to the cockpit by the look of it. Putting these hoses in, and then we've got some more plates to put around the battery terminal that we put in earlier. So let's have a look how we get on with this one. Put the nose switches back in place. The nose switches, why do I need to do that, Nick? Because I've been taking them off all the time. I haven't used them. Put the nose switches back in place. What's the nose switches? Have I missed something? There was something about nose switches, was there? It didn't tell me about those. Stand by. I'm just gonna have a look. Press the part. It doesn't say anything about the switches in the nose, Nick. Hasn't asked me to do that yet. You're making me look. The nose section just needs a lot of reinforcement with panels. It hasn't told me to do anything about that nose section with those switches. I don't know, Nick. We'll see. It's a car crash, so we'll see what happens. Right, we've looked through that. Yeah, the sensor and the cutoff switch. Yeah, but it hasn't asked me to put it anywhere, has it? Let me go back to this one. This was the first one we did. There was nothing in there. Let's go to the second one we did, which is this one. Oops. Make the press together. Install four batteries. Turn on the main switch. We've done that. We did that. We did that. We did that. We've done that. We've done that. We've done that. Nothing there. And then look in this one. Just looking around. Got the switches there. We've put them in. We put the plates on. We've done this bit here. It hasn't asked me to do that, Nick. Yeah, the sensor and cutoff switch. It hasn't asked me to touch them. It just said make sure that they're put down the forward end of the nose. I can still get to them. So, we'll see what happens. Should have been done when the nose was connected to the wings. Well, I don't blimmin' know. It doesn't tell me to do that. I'll have to have a look. I'll do that afterwards. There must have been a hole then for it to go in, yeah? You're probably right. You've got a cut-off switch so that if it's down, it won't go into the up position. I know what you mean, right? I can see where it's got to go. Okay. So that cut-off switch there is going to be going down there. Right, okay. I'll put that in later, Nick. I'm not doing it now. Oh, things going wrong already. I don't remember doing that, I have to say. Now I've lost what page I was up to. What are we doing? We've done 88, we've done 87, we've done 86. Right, we're on 89. Everything I do now isn't really going to interfere with that nose section, so I will fix that afterwards. We've got lots of pipe work here. Let's have a look what we've got. You've panicked me, Nick. You panicked me. Okay, so we've got different kinds of pipes. Wow, we've got lots of pipes. How am I supposed to tell the difference between all these pipes? Okay, so I'm guessing that's A. Let's lay these out. This big one's C. This sort of weird one here is definitely E. This non-assuming one must be B. This one over here must be F, which means this one here, A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay, we're good. Identify hoses A, B, and C and fit on the port side. All right, okay. So we need the bloody thing over again. Right, hang on a second. Oh dear. Right, okay. I'm going to try and bring it over. So you can see it. There we go. Right. Okay, so A, B, and C at once. And they're going on the port side into those three holes there. Okay, so fit the lower ends A, B, and C into the three holes indicated in step 5. A drop of super glue applied with a cockstick at the inset will help secure these firmly, but it doesn't tell you where they go. So I've got a bundle of wires. Oh, I don't know, but you've got the two. Let me figure this. These are tiny holes, so these go at the back. But they don't tell you what way round they go. They're obviously going towards this section at the back here. Where do they go into? Stand by. Fit the upper end of C into this. All right, there's holes at the top. Right, so we're putting the upper ends in first. Okay, I'm looking. I can see one hole there. Am I missing something? Oh dear, right, okay, hang on. We've already got a pipe in this hole. Stand by. It's just gone. Right, we've got two on the side. I can see now. Right, okay, we are going to use glue for this, I think. Let me get some glue out. What's the time? Okay, we've got 10 minutes to do these pipes. I'm going to do this. Right, take A. Right, so A was this one. Take the top of up A and it's going on the top, right. So A is going into this hole right here. You can never have too many tweezers. I can't believe I'm gluing tonight as well. Right, that's A in. B is going into the side. And C is going into... Oh, I put that in the wrong one already. Hang on. Car crash Tuesday. Right, so... they want this. Please work, something work. Okay, we've got two holes here. A is going in that one. Excellent. Let's put B in. B is going into the one just above it. Can't keep this up. Put it in my mouth. Can't get it in the hole. Stand by. There you go, A and B are in, and C is this really big long one, which is going into the one that I initially put this one in. Down here. Excellent. And that one's in as well. I'm going to let that glue dry and then we're going to have to attach them to the other side. So while we're doing that, we may as well do the same thing on the other side. Just seeing how they go. E is the bottom one, the smaller one's at the top, right, okay. Stand by. Oh God, I can't even see the holes again in this one. There's no holes in this side. Oh, stand by. We've got two holes right at the back, it says. Ah, here they are. Yep. So this one's going into the bottom hole. There we go. The next one, which is the shorter one, F, is going to the hole just above it. Excellent. And then the big one is going into the large hole that I've got here. This is scary. It's right at the back. Nope. And there we go. That's that one in. Wow. Now we've got to attach all of these to the floor. I'm having a break. The crash is beginning. Believe me. Because it wants all of these put into these holes in the floor now. Now, do I put glue into the things at the bottom? One. Get this left side in first and we'll have a look at that. I'll put that one in afterwards. Yeah, they're going to need to have glue in the bottom as well. I apologize if you can't see this. It's this is a cameraman's nightmare. So I'll put the longest one that's going in the corner in first, which is this one. I can't really see what I'm doing. Stand by. Right, one's in. The secret is to hold it right down the base. Two's in. And then two's back out again. Two is in. And lastly, number three. Three's in. Wow. You need to check this, look. Look. Look how much I'm sweating. Oh my God. It's so beautiful, it's a pain in the ass. This is like my ex-worker who yelled at God and other things alone. I mean, one side's gone in, I don't think the other side's going to go in as well. I mean, it looks impactful having all those pipes and stuff, but I don't know. It's a lot of stuff. We've got 5 minutes to put in that other side. I'm sure we can do this. Let's do this. Okay, so once again, I'm going to put some glue just down the points at the bottom. Matter of fact, we've got different places for these now. We've got two there. Ah, there is three. They're all down the bottom by the look of it. There's one up here. What's that one? Ah, F's going in there. Okay. So F was the shorter one of these. So that's this one. We'll put that one in last. So that means this one here, the big thick one, is going in. That one there, right, okay. One. Number two. That one's gone in fine. And number three just goes into this console panel there. Oh my God, look, it worked. There you go. All the pipes are in. Let me just move that glue so we don't get that in the way. Now we've done that, we're almost finished. We've just got to put these two plates on. And they're going to be going, let's pick this back up again. And then move some of the cameras around. Like that, I guess. Move this camera. Put this up here. And then this one, these two plates here are going to go either side of the battery housing. So the battery housing's here. Oh, which is coming off again. One, two. They go in, but they don't stay in very well, I have to say. Where do they go? So they're going around this section over here. So this one's going in, I'm guessing, this side. And it's still popping out. And then the other one's going to go in the other side. That does help to hold that in, just so you know, those two sides there. I'm guessing we're going to be screwing that in a second. Let's have a look. Nope, doesn't say we're screwing it. That's it. That's all we have to do. Ah, oh, so we managed to get up to stage 89. That don't look too bad, does it? We got up to stage 89 tonight. So that means we've got 90, 91, 92, 93, 94. I've still got six more to go through. That wasn't so much of a car crash, was it? Well, these Tuesday nights take it out of me. I'm telling you, they're so stressful. I thought that was going to be an easy one tonight, but then everything's happened. And then Nick telling me I've got to put the landing cutoff switch in, and I can see where it goes. I can't think why I haven't put that in, but I will get that in. So that obviously we don't want the wings opening when it's on the ground, and that will cause something to break. But I hope you enjoyed that tonight. I hope my stress is my schadenfreude for you. Tomorrow for the Patreons, we're going to be doing the Iron Man. Seeing how many episodes of that we go through. That's going to be a car crash as well, I'm sure it is. If you're not a Patreon, then by all means, just go over to my Patreon channel. You'll be able to join us from a little as a dollar. And you can see all the back catalogue stuff, all the behind-the-scenes stuff. We have a fun old time over there. But I'm going to have a nice stiff rum now. And then lie down. Why do I do these Tuesday night streams? I don't know. You need to glue down the battery housing. It won't stay down as it is. Fake space junk. It has been a minor fender bender tonight, but we got there in the end. Anyway, listen, thank you all for joining me. And until, if you're not a patron, I will see you on Thursday. Take care.